We're not in our solar system anymore. Starter A-frame deep space has all kinds of weird planets, and every time you refresh, you'll get new planets. That's because we're using custom shaders that use procedural generation to randomly generate new textures. You could have red stars, green stars, blue stars, volcanic planets, icy planets, rocky planets. It's pretty interesting. We also have these cool buttons, and these use JavaScript. It's an example of how to use JavaScript to make your scenes way more interactive. We'll show you how. Let's take a look at Starter A-frame Deep Space. I'm going to create a new remix so I can play around with the code and see how it works. Once again, our code opens to this handy README. Let's check out the scene. Click Show to view it. As you can see, our planets have different textures. And every time you refresh, they'll change slightly. In previous starters, we used images to texture our spheres. Now we're using something called shaders. These generate textures based on code. Let's look at our own code to see how it's done. I've included shaders in scripts tags in our index.html. And you might notice that they're glitch projects. If you head to the README, you can learn more about them. You can even remix them to make your own cool shaders. I'm going to head back to index to show you how I use them. So when I want to take a shader and apply it to something like a sphere, I use the shader's name as an attribute. For example, here's star, and it has the star shader attribute. Some of these shaders even have their own values inside of them. Like metallic planet has metallic planet shader, and inside of it is a value for volcanism. Let's open our planetarium in a new window. And let's resize it so we can see both the planetarium and the code at the same time. That way, as we change the code, we can see what happens to the planetarium. Here is the metallic planet in the planetarium. And here it is in the code. We'll change this value from metallic planet shader from volcanism 0 to volcanism 1. Look, we've made this planet a volcanic planet too. Awesome. What about taking a shader from one planet and putting it on another planet? So this Terra planet, it looks pretty nice, and I'm going to apply it to rocky planet. So first I'll take the Terra shader and copy it. Then I'll paste it into metallic planet. Finally, I'll remove the metallic planet shader. If you take a look, you can see now both these planets have the Terra shader. We hope you've enjoyed playing with shaders in your planetarium. Check out the README for more information on how shaders work and how to customize them. We're excited to see what you build.
I was thinking that maybe having just a shelf of ideas would be a nice thing. Maybe it's like a shelf that there are different things that I rotate in and out. It could be maybe like books that I'm thinking about or books that I really like, or libraries or things that people have written recently that I really like. Maybe some images, but just kind of like a contemplative space that you can like choose to explore different parts of. I've also thought of doing, I kind of like this idea of like having kind of convoluted scenes and hiding things in them. So almost like creating like, if like I Spy were in WebVR or something like that. Because something that I found with like working on this website where you're putting paintings all over the room is that often people can't tell. Some things are very obvious what is digitally manipulated, but some things just like can go like right past you and not knowing if it's actually part of the scene or not. And so I think that that is just kind of a fun thing and that there's more to be explored there.
The buttons in this scene are custom components. Let's take a look at the scene to see how they work. You interact with them using this pink dot, which is called a cursor in A-frame. When you move your head up and down in VR, you're moving the cursor. On a desktop, you click and drag. Once the cursor is on the button, you can click with your VR headset or mouse to pause it. Now, let's go down to the other button to restart it. The restart button works the same as the pause button. Let's head to the code to see how they work. The code for the pause button is in index.html. It's written in this script tag up here. I use A-frame register component to let A-frame know there's a new component called pause button. The button has an event listener. It listens for a click, and when it's clicked, the function inside here runs. It takes all the orbits and emits this event called pause orbit. The orbit animation has a pause events attribute, and we pass that pause orbit event into it. So when pause orbit is run, that will pause anything using the orbit animation. We use our custom component the same way we use any component, by using its name as an attribute. The restart button is almost exactly the same, but the code is not in index.html. Instead, it's in a separate file called restartbutton.js. Let's take a look. It's very similar, except it emits the start orbit event. This also goes in the orbit animation, in the attribute for resume events. Putting the JavaScript in a separate file makes it easier to organize it. You can also import it into many different scenes.
So in this series, we gave you an overview of what A-frame is and how to build scenes both simple and complex using it. For more information about A-frame, go to the documentation site at aframe.io/docs. And if you get stuck while using Glitch, just highlight the code and you can ask the community for help.